the... Yuck.
What's up, everybody, and good morning. Today is a day we are getting started on this automatic Z. Some of you guys might know this car. The guy's name is Gustavo. You might have seen him on Mike's channel. This car might look familiar to you. It was the car, actually, that he surprised him at his high school with.
That's my car?
Yeah, that's yours.
No, dude, no.
And put on the body kit. He's since done a couple of things. Gustavo, homie, we gotta talk, dude. But some good things are happening to this. For a while, he's been hitting me up and talking about changing to a manual swap, a manual transmission swap, and I think we're about to do it today. He brought a whole gang of parts for me. He's been putting this together for about 3 to 6 months, but he has everything now. So we have the transmission, we have the drive shaft, we have a whole array of parts over here that I will get into in just a second, but I want to explain it all to you. So let's get started. Okay, so as you can see, I have all of the parts kind of laid out here. There's the transmission and the drive shaft over there. Those are the main parts. You guys know what those are. Kind of go over and explain some of the stuff that's necessary. This is, I don't even know if this is necessarily necessary, but it's good to have. It's the manual swap with the shifter boot. Just plugs right into the back right here. And so that's pretty easy. This is a bag full of bolts. It's all of the transmission bolts and washers and stuff that go for the bell housing to the engine. Next we have, he got a Z1 poly mount. I highly recommend this. I run this on my Z. Anybody that I do this swap for, or anybody that's trying to upgrade the feel of their transmission, this is a great thing. It's from Z1. Most of these parts actually are from Z1, but that's a great thing to have. Also, the cross member. Actually, the one thing he is missing is the bolt that goes through this, but I might be able to use his, the weighted one. If not, I'll use mine. I'll explain that a little bit later. Next is the pilot bearing. So on a manual transmission for the input shaft, this pilot bearing actually is different. When you pull the transmission, there's a much bigger one that meets for the torque converter. I'll explain that when I get into that, but we will be having to pull out the old one and put in this new one. And then next is the throwout bearing. We have the pivot fork, the pivot ball for the shift fork. We have the shift fork, and then we have this line is for the slave cylinder. The braided line is a good feel. It's a good upgrade. And since he doesn't have one right now, it's gonna feel good just as it is. Next is the master cylinder. It comes with the reservoir. This will just bolt in place. And then there's a master cylinder. This nut is already set. No adjustment really necessary for that. We'll see how his pedal feels, but besides that, it should be pretty straightforward. The only two things that I do have to do is I have to make holes for this. There is no template in there, especially on an automatic car. The only thing that I have as a guide at all is a little piece of cutout where the firewall pad is at, and I'll explain that in a bit. But yeah, this might be a little bit interesting because you have to change, or you have to actually install the clutch pedal. He got the clutch pedal assembly. And because on a automatic, the brake pedal is much bigger, you also change the brake pedal, which has a much smaller pad. So that way when all three of them next to each other, you're not stepping over it. The pad on the brake one is huge. excuse me. And then there's the clutch, the flywheel, the pressure plate, all this together. And then there's the lines. So there's no lines ran for an automatic trans, so obviously you have to get the one that actually will come up off of here, like this. This will actually go into here, and then this goes through the fender well and down on the driver's side, and then this kind of loops around till you get to the block where you will actually put this, and then that will go to the slave, and then it'll actually be hooked up. So last but not least, we have Hexa. Thank you for doing this. They did the gnats removal on this because when you are changing from an automatic to a manual, there's a couple different ways you can go about it. You can wire in the trans switch, but it's much easier if you change the ECU. And yeah, other than that, that's pretty much, I mean, it's not pretty much for the swap. It sounds like a lot, and it is kind of a lot. It's kind of extensive, but all of the parts being together, we should be able to knock this out in 1, maybe 2 days. This is actually gonna be one of the first ones that I've done. I've helped and actually seen somebody else do it, but I have never done it myself. So I'm kind of taking you on this journey with me, and I'm excited to show you exactly what's going on. So with that being said, let's get started. Okay, so now that we have the car in the air, I can kind of show you everything that's going on. Standard automatic transmission, you have the drive shaft. This is that bolt that I was talking about. I'm pretty sure we can use that one, so I won't have to use mine. Okay, but pretty straightforward. So you can see the series of bolts that go around the belt housing. I believe there's 1, 2, 2 on top, 3, 4, 17s. There's the 2 14s that hold the starter in. There's 2 14s down here at the bottom. I'll explain it more as I go along as well, that come off. And then the other thing you have to do is there's torque converter bolts. There's 4 of them, they're 14 millimeter. You have to spin the crank. I'll have to take this off as well. Spin the crank to get to them in the window, which will be right underneath here. So I'll have to take this plastic shield off as well. But there'll be 4 of them to separate the torque converter from the flex plate. So as I go along, I'll explain more on that. But I'll take off these 2 14s. I'll take off these 2 14s to take this bracket out of the way. And then it's just pretty much undo the wire harness and start taking it out. These aren't too bad to pull out. First thing you do want to do though is empty the fluid, because once you take the drive shaft out, it'll start spilling out. And once you remove the torque converter, that will also be something that leaks. So that being said, pretty straightforward. Let's get started. Okay, so I've gone ahead and taken off all of the boring stuff. You can see over there, just all of the covers, all the stuff that's covering everything underneath here. I also drained all the oil or the fluid. And so now you can kind of see everything that's going on in here. The bolts are pretty easy to get to. These are the 2 14s in here. I know the light's kind of bad, but there's a 14 on this side and the 14 on this side. I'm trying to change the light so you can see it. There you go. And then there's the 10 that you can see in the center right there. That's actually for the window in here. Man, it's really hard to show. But there's a window right there that you take off, and that's where you get the 14 millimeter, the 4 of bolts for the torque converter. So then you can see here, there's this 14 and this 14 for this cover here. It just blocks the hole for the starter if it was a right-hand drive car. It's really easy to take off. And then there's the 17, there's the other 17 up top. And then there's 2 that are directly on top of the transmission. And I found that it's much easier. My light is dying. I found that it's much easier to go from the top to get those 2 bolts out. So I will show you that in a bit. And then there's these 2 14s. Keep track of those. Those are a special length for the starter. And then you'll take the starter off, kind of set it in there. I highly recommend taking off the negative battery cable, because if you touch the positive that's over here, it'll start sparking and all kinds of fun things will happen. So take off the negative, then take off the starter. And then there's 1 more 17 that's up there that you can get. I actually have a very long extension. You can get them at Harbor Freight, whatever. I think it's 18 inch, you can get 24 inch. These work really well, especially on the back of a gun, like a half inch drive electric impact. And you'll just put it through here, and with a wobble socket, it'll come right off. And so that'll be all the bolts around the bell housing here. I do have to take the 14 off here, so that way this is free from the transmission, and then I'll unplug the O2 sensors to kind of get this out of my way. And then the only thing I really have to do left is the 4 17s for the drive shaft. And there's also a 14 nut you can see right here that goes to the shift linkage. This will kind of just sit down, and then you can take off the bolts here and here. And I have a transmission jack that I'll put underneath the pan here and let it sit down. But I'll explain more as I go along. So If you guys haven't invested in these, if you're doing something, these mountain wrenches, Monster Mountain, they're the same wrench, really, really good extension. You can change the direction of them. You've heard me talk about them before. These are what I use a lot of. The head actually bends, and you can do and get pretty much anywhere. The throw on them is really short, so you don't have to have a lot of room to be able to break something loose. So I have two sets of these actually. They work really well. I suggest if you guys are doing stuff like this to definitely invest in these. So I'm gonna start breaking bolts loose and I will get back in just a second. Okay, so as you can see, I have that window open in there and I know it's really hard to see, but if you look through there, there is 14s that hold the torque converter on. I'm trying to get, if I look through here, there you can see that one bolt right there. There's actually four of those in there and they're a little difficult to get to. You'll have to try different extensions to be able to break them loose. The one thing that I do is hold a breaker bar on here. This is a 19 on the crank and I can kind of use the breaker bar to hold that still while I break that loose with a ratchet. They're not on there real tight, or at least they shouldn't be. So that's definitely something that you can do. And there's four of them. And after you do that, then the torque converter will be completely free of the engine. Okay, so I'm working on the last bolt in here. What I found is I have this snap-on extended quarter inch drive with a flexible head and a 14 standard length. Well, it's a long, but the standard length, it's not like a 3/4 or whatever. And I use it to kind of just get up in there like that, and it's enough that I have enough room with turning the crank to break the bolts off. So I have three done. You can see that one's missing now. Three of them are done. I'm gonna do the fourth one, and then I know that the transmission will be able to separate from the engine. So yeah, working right along. The last thing I realized is, do you see these long lines that go to the transmission? They actually kind of follow here, go up underneath here, and then come out here. And it's so that way there's a cooler for the transmission. You'll have to take these lines off, and then there's like a 10 here, a 10 holding this bracket here. I'm gonna take the 17s off there, and then I'll pull the transmission out, and then I can kind of like pull these and feed them out this way. So yeah, the transmission line, the cooler lines, that was the last thing that I realized. Okay, and these are the four torque converter bolts. And let me kind of show you what I've been doing. It's just taking stuff off, to be honest. I took off the connector here, and I also took off the connector here. I separated the O2 sensors, kind of tucked them back, so you can see that there's nothing in this area for when the transmission comes down. I also took the 10 millimeter bolt, the bolt out of here, and then I've just been disconnecting like the harness. I also took the two 10s that were holding that bracket for this connector that's right here, this black connector. There's one up on top you can see, and then there's the one that's attached to the side of the transmission. So all of this is pretty much free. The dipstick I'll get from up top because it's actually bolted to the pipe up there. You can see the bracket that kind of goes to the pipe. And the last thing I'm going to do is take these 17s off, so this kind of dangles for the oil cooler piping, and then I'll lower it down and take off the rest of the bell housing bolts. And so there's that one that's up there, and then there's this one, that one, and the two up top I'll get from up top as well. And then all the bell housing bolts will be off, so the only thing holding the transmission in will be the cross member, but then I can pull the transmission puller over here, put it up underneath here, take this off, and then kind of lower it down and get it out of my way. And then I have to take off the drive shaft, which will be those four, and then it will really come out. So I am going to start taking off the bell housing bolts, and then I'll lower the car down and show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so I had to lower the car down. There's one last bolt on the drive shaft that I can't get to, so I need to put the car in neutral, and then I'll be able to spin it. But before I do that, I want to show you guys in here that there's actually quite a bit of room in here. You can get your arm in here, especially with those mountain wrenches, you're able to have a large extension to be able to break the bolts loose on the transmission, the upper bell housing bolts. So as you can see, there's one down over here that's kind of off to the side, more towards the driver. There's two up top, And then there's one that's kind of under all this mess. You can either get it from up here or you can get it from down below. I do it both ways. And then there is also the 210s or the 110 that's holding the dipstick tube right here on the transmission that you can get just under this wire harness. And so this makes it a lot easier to get these upper bell housing bolts. And then after you take those off, I'll raise the car up and I'll be able to spin the drive shaft, take the drive shaft out. And then the only thing that's left is taking the trans mount that holds the trans member up to the body. And then we'll use the trans jack and pull the big bastard out of there. So yeah, we're almost there. It's only been like an hour, and with me vlogging, it takes a little bit more time. I'm trying to show you guys a step-by-step. I know that I'm not doing like each individual bolt and stuff, but there's a lot that needs to be done on this. So I'm not trying to make it a super long video. I might even have to make this into two videos. I don't want to lose your guys' interest, and I want you guys to be able to see everything that's going on. So that being said, I'm going to take these bolts out of the top here. I'll raise it back up and we'll pull the drive shaft out and get the transmission out of here. Okay, so I'm back in the air. You can see I have the drive shaft is now pulled out. I also have the shift linkage right here. It's completely disassembled. It'll just stay on there as part of that. One thing I wanted to show you guys, a lot of people overlook, there is a bolt. Do you see that bolt right there underneath the starter that's going into the transmission? A lot of people will overlook that and not understand why, or try and force the transmission to come out. So make sure you guys get that. It's a 17 as well. It's just going the opposite way. I don't know why Nissan did that, but yeah, make sure you get that bolt. So I have that one. I have that one that's up there. And then this one. And we will be pulling the transmission out. Okay, and then so I'll put a little bit of pressure up on this so I can take off this, which is the mount bolt. The mount actually sits inside this like cradle right here. So I'll take this off first, and then I can take the 14s off, and then this whole thing will come out. Okay, and I got the 14s off. You can see the plates over there. So now it's ready to come out. So you can see it's already starting to separate. I'm not gonna be able to show this very much because it's just me by myself, and I'm gonna need to like kind of sturdy this, work the jack, lower it down, maneuver, those type of things. So, but you can see it's already separated. It's not even attached to the engine much anymore. So I'll kind of just lower it down a little bit and pull it back, lower it down and kind of wiggle it out. So it's coming out. And just like that, it's out. So I put a strap around this since I did do it on my own. I didn't want it to slide off and me not be able to catch it or whatever. So good thing to do is I just put the strap here over, cinched it down, and then I was able to kind of finagle it and move it out. But everything's out, all the wiring sitting there. So I'll have to pull out. This is the pilot bearing I was telling about. This is a lot bigger than that little brass one I was telling you. So I need to get a slide hammer, yank that out, and then I'll install the new one before the new tranny goes in. Okay, now that the transmission is out, we are going to need this. It is a pilot bearing tool. Here's the number 467033, and I think this is 67031 if you guys go to O'Reilly's. This is a slide hammer. This goes on the end of it. And what you do is you actually put this in where the pilot bearing is at. Let me show you. This will go inside there, and then you'll slide hammer, and this actually pulls out. So that's way too big. We can't fit the new flywheel over it. And so we are going to pull that out to be able to put the new bronze one in. Okay, so this is the old one that comes out. That's what it looks like. And then this brass one is the new one, and that actually goes in the center like that. So I usually get a socket that fits around the outside and tap it in. Be careful not to do the ones on the inside. Make sure it doesn't hit on the inside, because if it caves in, it's gonna be that much smaller. And this is pretty much an exact fit for the input shaft on the new transmission. And you will struggle to put it in if by any chance these get bent in or it deforms the perfect circle that it is. So be careful of that. But right now I'm gonna install it. Okay, and like that, you see it's in. I have the outside flush with kind of where the flat part right here meets. It doesn't have to be pushed in all the way. So I have it flush there. I'll put a little bit of grease in there so that way when the input shaft goes in, it slides in nice and tight. But as you can see with the clutch alignment tool, it goes right in. There's no issues. There's a little bit of play that'll actually help me when the transmission's trying to line up, but I didn't damage the outside. It goes in, no problem. Okay, so the bolts that come off of the flex plate are different than the ones that hold the flywheel on. Make sure you get different ones. These are the ones that come off the flex plate for the automatic trans. The ones that you want are these ones. It's a T50 head, and they're a little bit longer. You can see also in here how long they need to be to go into the crank, so the other ones will not work. Do not use them. When I do flywheels, I make sure that I use at least blue Permatex. Some people use red. I feel like the blue, after you suck them in, does just fine, holds them tight. I've never had an issue with it. So I'll put a little bit thread locker on each of them and then install the flywheel. Okay, so now installed, you can see all the bolts are in there, and this is a T55, not a T50, sorry. But it's a T55, they're all torqued on. Now, time for the clutch. Okay, so first things first, you'll see the clutch disc has a flat side, has a side that sticks out. The side that sticks out goes towards the pressure plate. So when you see it like this, it will go in here like this. The flat surface goes against the flywheel. Just to clear that up. Next thing that I do is I will actually put the clutch disc on like that. Should stay held like that. When you put this over top of it, then you'll be able to pull it out and it'll stay perfectly centered. So just a little trick that I do, and then I'll put the new bolts in, and then I'll be able to pull this out and it'll be perfectly centered. Okay, and I have the clutch is all in. You can see that I have it greased up. I have all the bolts around, including the washer on every single one of them. And it's important to see that the red part is touching the flywheel. If there's space between there, it needs to go tighter. I've seen it where those weren't completely tight, and when you get the transmission in and ready to try it while it's running to shift, it won't disengage. So make sure that the red part here on, I know it's hard to see, the red part here on the pressure plate is touching the flywheel with the bolts fully tight. But it's time to put the throwout bearing in the transmission and raise it up in here. Okay, so now is time to install the throwout bearing. It's actually a two-piece from Nissan. This is like the main part, and then you can actually buy bearings that are just the sleeve. This actually gets pressed onto here. What I usually do is I find a piece of wood. Don't use a piece of metal, don't use the ground, use a piece of wood, because this actually spins on here and you don't want this to get damaged. I will put it face down and then I'll put this on here, and I kind of whack this with a hammer because this part in the center, you can see that's moving, actually just goes to the center and won't push all the way through. It'll just sit down on this lip right here. So yeah, be careful with that. Maybe use another piece of wood or something on here when you hit it, but it should go together pretty easy. The other thing, I had to take off the stubby pivot ball for this one. This one's a little bit longer, and I'll just install that on here for the shift fork. And then this is the shift fork, and I'll show how this goes together. But essentially that this part right here actually sits on the pivot ball. This will go through here, and this will kind of do that and sit on here just like that. So I'm gonna put this together and I'll show you it installed. Okay, so I hammered this together. You can see kind of where the sleeve sits. Everything is sitting flat on it. And then, let me get the light for you. I installed the pivot ball right there. So you can see that's tight. And now the last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean up right here because the throwout bearing actually sits along this collar right here and needs to be lubricated heavily. I'm gonna lubricate every part that's gonna be moving, metal to metal, you name it. So I'm gonna do that now, and then I'll put together the shift fork with the pilot bearing, I mean the throwout bearing, and show you it installed. Thank you.